Welcome to the new features of ColorAnt 9. We added a new workflow tool next to the auto tool where a user can load previously saved custom workflows for automation. This is very useful to save time rather than performing the same function repeatedly. Creating your own workflow is very easy. Load a file into ColorAnt, then select the optimization tools that you would normally use on the file. Next, right-click on the file to bring up the context menu and select Create Workflow. The dialog shows the tools and settings used for the workflow. At the bottom of the dialog, you can name your workflow and click on Save Workflow. The workflow is saved as an XML file in the ColorAnt Workflows folder, which is in the User Documents folder. You can easily copy and paste, import or export to another system. Click on the workflow icon to bring up the workflow tool. Select the specific workflow that you would like to use and click on Start. Click on the magnifying glass icon to look at the settings of a specific workflow. If you want to rename the workflow, just click on the pencil icon. And to delete a workflow, just click on the trash can icon. In addition to reading mixed CSV files, which means files that contain multiple data sets, you can now save these files directly from ColorAnt. Select Multiple Files, right-click, go to Data Import Export, and select Save as Combined CSV. The CIE Conversion tool has a different UI for LAB data. The UI still looks the same for spectral data, but if you select LAB data, then the UI changes to show a source illumination chooser. The purpose of this is to show colorimetric data that will be converted into a different illumination using a color appearance model. The Color Editor tool also has a new helpful addition in the form of a new warning icon below the colors if any of the three are out of the monitor's gamut. In the comparison dialog, there is a new tab for a comparison report. Here, you can view and save a comparison report based on the sort order. The evaluation tool has been updated with the latest Fogra PSD values for 2022. In addition, there is also support for the new Fogra Media Wedge for RGB with the corresponding new evaluation method. For the validation print, we now differ between a smaller wedge evaluation and a bigger chart evaluation. According to the ISO, all patches evaluation excludes some defined boundary patches, which are not shown for corresponding wedges. For bigger or full charts, such as the IT8, these boundary patches are taken into account for the all patches evaluation, and they will also get their own additional evaluation. In Preferences, there is a new option called Automatically Reorder Known Charts. If you were to enable this checkbox, a randomized ITA chart such as this will automatically be reordered to the known visual style. If this option is disabled, then the same randomized ITA chart will be shown as is. You can switch between modes by holding down the Alt key. In the Tone Value tool, the .txt format is a new export type. This is helpful for some RIPs that require .txt format for curves. There are also a few changes in the View tool. For example, there is a text view mode where you can directly see and edit the text file. In the 3D view, you have the option to enable or disable the grid, axes, or axes labels. In Measure Tool, there are new features for the Barbieri LFP device. Now you can measure in transmission mode, and there is support for the new auto positioning and recognition modes. These are just several new visible features, but we've also enhanced a lot under the hood as well. Feel free to try out the new version of ColorAnt. Thanks for watching.